Giroud to Chelsea. What a big transfer. £18 million. Are you absolutely crazy, Arsenal? Before we get into the video, I want you guys to go ahead and smash out the like button down below. Also, subscribe to the channel if you are new. Turn on those post notifications. And you can comment in the comment section down below if you guys want to be in for shout out of the day in the next video as well. Goldbucks.com/bros.game if you guys want to donate for free. Yeah. All you have to do is download apps, you can play games, you can do whatever you want on your phone, downloading apps, playing games obviously, progress throughout the game, it gives you money and you can actually donate that, so yeah, free. Unless you count time as cost, I would count time as cost, so yeah, donate your time, appreciate that. So Giroud has joined Chelsea for 15, yeah, we thought it was 18 and we were like, wow, £18 million, that's cheap for Giroud, but no, £15 million plus add-on, so it will come to about £18 million, but £15 million up front has joined Chelsea. Giroud to Chelsea, it's weird. I'm talking about a player who's played 253 games for Arsenal, scored 105 goals and got 41 assists for Arsenal. He's definitely going to be one of those players that they don't realize they had until he's gone, and he's gone now, so Arsenal fans have to get over it. However, I don't feel like he signed the longest of contracts. A 2-year contract is not what you want to be seeing from a player who's just moved from Arsenal to Chelsea. To Chelsea, let's just say. A big club, they've signed a big player on a 2-year contract. Don't get me wrong, he's 31 years of age, but I feel like his prime time is now. He's literally coming into his form. If you look at when he played at Montpellier, he played at other teams as well, he's actually scored a lot less when it comes to ratio at those clubs than he has at Arsenal, and he's only been at Arsenal for, I believe, 5 years, maybe even 6 years, and he scored 105 goals. I believe 50 goals in the Premier League, and only 7 Arsenal players have ever done that before. I mean, there's definitely going to be less gel in the dressing room, but I feel like Giroud is going to be missed, especially in the dressing room. Every interview you watch of an Arsenal player, they talk about Giroud. Literally, you say, which player's got the best music? Which player's got the best dance moves? Everybody literally points out Giroud for everything, not dance moves. Who looks the best? Giroud. But it is literally like they are fascinated, or maybe even friends with Giroud, and obviously have that little bit of friendship to mention him in their interviews. And I feel like that was a big thing that Arsenal probably could have done with and kept at the club. Like I said, Aubameyang have joined their club, Lacazette has joined their club, Mkhitaryan has joined their club. Have any of them got leadership skills like Giroud had? Apparently not, and apparently Giroud hasn't got those leadership skills either. Apparently he wanted to move to Borussia Dortmund on a 6-month loan. Yep. Loan, not a permanent deal, so he wouldn't be coming back to Arsenal anyway. But get this, his wife said no, she wants to stay in London. She doesn't see the appeal of Germany. She wants to stay in London, she likes the country, she likes the city, and she wants to stay in London. And Giroud's like, yo, what am I supposed to do here? I mean, my wife's saying this, my wife's saying that, what am I supposed to do? That was a bad accent, I know. His only option was literally to go to another club in London, and if he went to West Ham, is he gonna get first team football there? I would have said yes. I think West Ham need a new striker. Tottenham Hotspur definitely wouldn't have got first team football there. Chelsea were the third club in London, I would have thought top tier club. I would have thought that he would have gone to, and he obviously has picked them. They've got a record of Champions League trophies, something Arsenal seem to be lacking. Liverpool also have those, but they weren't interested. Sorry for the shot. So Chelsea have literally taken Arsenal's plan B and made him their plan A. Chelsea are starting to turn into Arsenal where a few years ago they were literally just farming players off and bringing in players and trying to, like, bringing in players that were past their sell-by date in a way. They were literally too old to progress, but old enough to still maintain at their level, if that makes sense. And that's what Arsenal used to do, and now it seems like Chelsea's starting to do that as well. It's gonna be a short one, because I don't really know much about the deal. Obviously, I know that Chelsea signed him so that they could get rid of Batshuayi on a loan deal, so Batshuayi will be coming back to Chelsea, but he has gone on loan to Dortmund, and then Dortmund sold Aubameyang to Arsenal so that Arsenal could sell Giroud to Chelsea. It's just a weird triangle, it's just all weird. How can literally 3 separate deals not collapse? Like, one out of those 3 deals surely would collapse. Nope, every single deal went through. And I'm not gonna lie, I was surprised about that. I thought one of them would have collapsed and maybe all of them would have fell through because of the one collapsing, and obviously that's not the way it's gone. Arsenal have been lucky this season. Mkhitaryan went through for Alexis, and then this one went through as well. It's crazy. A little bit of a short video, but it is a double upload, and hopefully you guys have enjoyed it. First shout out of the day though goes out to my boy Paul Kendall. If you guys wanna be here for shout out of the day, all you have to do is follow me on Instagram, Snapchat, or Twitter, and then be active on any of those social media. So obviously I see you, you see me, and I shout you. Simple. Don't know what this was. But yeah, if you want to be in for shout out of the day, all you have to do is follow any of them. Or you could donate using goldbox.com/brosgotgame, which makes you a priority because you're supporting the channel. So yeah, you can do that as well. It's free. Okay, so time to rate the transfer out of 5 stars then. I'm going to go with Chelsea and give them a 4-star rating for this transfer, simply because they got him pretty cheap. 18 million is cheap for a player that scored 105 goals. It literally doubled that amount of games. So he's got a 0.5 goal record. Well, near enough, 0.5 goal record, maybe a little bit less than that, so 0.4 or 0.48, something like that. But yeah, pretty good record at the end of the day. I think he's gonna definitely come good for Chelsea if he gets the service. If he doesn't get the service, obviously not. But I feel like when Giroud gets the ball in the box, he tends to score a lot of his chances. And that's what Chelsea are lacking at the moment. Morata wasn't putting it in the back of the net. Now he's injured. Batshuayi came, kind of done the job in a way. He scored a couple of goals against Newcastle. Wasn't really scoring before that. Obviously scored an own goal. We've saw that before as well. But I feel like Batshuayi was doing an all right job. But when they're bringing Giroud, you just got that reassurance that he's going to do the job. Arsenal. 1 star. Yeah, 1 star. I actually gave them 5 stars for the Aubameyang deal. They get a 1 star for the Giroud deal. And this is why. 18 million pounds for a player who scores so many goals in so many games, right? And had so many assists as well. Tends to put the ball into the back of the net when he has a shot as well. So his shot accuracy is really good. However, not only that, but Chelsea were willing to spend 30 million pounds on Andy Carroll. And then you've gone and sold Giroud for half of that. Andy Carroll and Peter Crouch. Giroud. 30 million, 15 million. Where is the logic, Arsenal? They're obviously willing to pay more than that. But not only that, I feel like he's probably worth more than that as well. Like I said, his shot accuracy is really good. He hasn't got the most pace in the world. He's got the height though, he's got the strength. He can hold the ball up well, and Chelsea need that. And they've literally just given it to them. 18 million pounds in this current market. That's a steal for Giroud. Shout out of the day goes out to my boy Nitai20, who said half a billion on defense. Lol. That was for the Manchester City video for Laporte joining for 57 or maybe even 60 million pounds to Manchester City, which can move up in add-ons, fees, wages, everything, move up to 105 million pounds. Is that worth it? I don't know. But one that I believe is worth it is the Giroud deal. Like I said, if you don't agree, then let me know why in the comments down below. If you do agree, let me know in the comments down below as well. Smash that like button, subscribe if you do, turn on those post notifications, donate using goldbox.com/brosgotgame as well. And you can also follow me on twitch.tv/brosgotgame as well, because the live streams, as you guys probably would have known if you watched yesterday, are in fact back. But yeah, it has been me. You guys have been great, and I'll catch you in the next one. Peace.